Yes, good afternoon to one and all. Our expert of today's webinar on waterproofing of structure is with us. So I, Engineer Sunita Kotwal, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department, along with my colleague, Engineer Sukhdeep Singh, Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department, welcome you all to this one-day webinar on waterproofing of structures. We welcome our guest, Engineer Vikas Malhotra Ji, General Manager, Technical Services, White Cement Division. We also welcome Mr. Sahil Verma. He is Senior Technical Executive, JK Cement Limited, Bathinda. And along with them, we welcome Mr. Rameshwar Singh and Mr. Jagdish Prasad Gupta Ji. Both of these members are from JK Cement. So we welcome you from our core of our heart. And first of all, as you all know, sir has delivered many lectures to you. जो लोग सर का लेक्चर पहले सुन चुके हैं वो सर को जानते हैं पर जो लोग सर को नहीं जानते तो first let me take the privilege to introduce sir with all the students of 2018 and 19 batches. So engineer Vikas Malhotra ji is BTech from PEC Chandigarh. He has done MBA from Punjab University Chandigarh. He has vast experience of 24 years in cement and concrete. He started his career with STP Limited and he worked there from August 95 to May 98. That is STP Limited, that the Times of India Group companies, that the pioneers in bitumen based structural waterproofing products as a sales executive and was later promoted as branch in charge Chandigarh, looking after Punjab, Chandigarh, Himachal Pradesh, J&K. Then in May 98 to September 99, he worked at Pidilite Industries as senior sales executive. He joined JK Cement in October 99 and worked there till January 2008 and worked as a deputy manager technical services with many key responsibilities. Then sir joined in February 2008 and worked there till April 2017, that is Jay Prakash Associates Limited. His designation was there as a regional manager technical services from April 14 till date. And then general, he worked as the deputy regional manager from April 2011 to March 2014. And now presently, sir is in JK Cement Limited as zonal head technical services. His designation is general manager technical service. So he is working with JK Cement, White Cement. There are two branches, that White Cement and Grey Cement. So sir is in White Cement. So we welcome you, sir, in this webinar. So your mic is off, please, you can on it.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot for a nice introduction and a warm welcome. Once again, I welcome all the students who are joining us today. And madam has given a little introduction, nothing much. I am just a simple person. I am a civil engineer by profession. And it's a matter of time that I am just 25 years ahead of you. So after 25 years, you all will be in, I wish you all will be in the same position to deliver such kind of lectures. So nothing is great. It is just time. And the only thing about time is that if you are investing your time in a proper manner, then certainly you will gain a lot in your life. But if you waste your time anywhere, at the places which are not required, then you may land up in a situation which is not so good. So that's about my introduction. Shall we start, ma'am, right away, or shall we wait for some other students to join?
Yes, sir, you can start.
Okay, I hope I can share my slide. Yes. Is the slide visible to all?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Yes, sir.
Visible, yes, sir.
I think so, friends. Not taking much of the time, I will directly start with the topic today. That's today I have selected. Earlier I have interacted with most of you many times. The topic was related to cement, durability of cement. We have done. And we have done value-added cement-based products also with you. So today, this is a very hot topic for all the civil engineers. As far as my experience goes, whenever you enter into any structure, any building, there is always some problem of waterproofing. So there are different reasons why water penetrates into the structure. The basic thing is, if you want to make your structures watertight, you have to identify the source first. So that is a basic reason. With that, I open the interaction and I will try to, you know, I have made this presentation in a very structured manner where you will get to know every problem, why water was coming and how we have solved it. And this is out of my personal experience. I have given some solutions also, how we can rectify the problem. So not taking much of the time, I will start with a little introduction of my company and then we will move to the topic. And of course, before that, since I am from a cement industry, I will touch upon cement also. So first will be the introduction of company, then a little bit about cement, and then we'll move to the topic, that is waterproofing of structures, and followed by two products, which is, you can say, my hidden agenda to introduce those two products to all of you, which goes with waterproofing of structure. Of course, they are from my company. So that's how we will move. And this is, friends, regarding today's scenario. There are challenges and opportunities both. So as I have started the delivery with a very positive note that you have to keep on learning, you have to keep on moving. The same applies in this situation also. Though there are many challenges, there is a challenge of health and safety, mental fitness, distance learning, difficulty in practical online training is there. Being a civil engineer, you are not able to move into the field to do all your training work. So that's a problem. Distance learning, as you are seeing, we are interacting. I'm at my place. Most of you must be at your place. So these are all the challenges. Job opportunities, of course, since the economy is in bad shape, opportunities will be, I won't say they will zero down, but they will be on the lower side. So you have to be ready for the opportunity. Nothing to get discouraged with all this. You have a lot of opportunities also. Now you will be surprised in this kind of situation and with respect to COVID-19, there are some opportunities also. What are those? You just have to find out. In each situation, there is something positive. So you just have to find out. So these can be few for you from your angle. The first one is a lot of time is available with all of you. It is more than normal for everybody, including me, including everybody is having more time than what was available earlier. The reason is that the time which was going in commutation to our respective places, like in my case, there was a lot of traveling. So traveling is not there. So a lot of time, not even going to office, sitting at home. So that extra time, you have to use it in a positive manner. It can be invested in your academics. It can be used to explore your passions. It's not always about studies. It can be anything. Passion can be learning some instrument or something. So basically, you should invest in a positive manner. And you, this is the right time, friends, to sharpen your presentation skills for those who are in third, fourth, or fifth final year. So they basically, when you will enter into the corporate world, presentation is very important. Knowing the thing and presenting the things. These are two different things. So you should know how to present the things, how to put your ideas in front of somebody. So that's it's a real time to learn this. A lot of time is available. Overall, this is a time to shift way of living. I personally feel that I'm not giving any negative statement, but I personally feel that this will be a great learning period for all of us. And there will certainly be some changes will be there, which we will have to follow forever. That's my personal thinking. So those changes, you can say it's a time to shift the way of living. So we have to adapt with those changes. And overall, we have to be positive in all this scenario. The one who is positive in all this scenario will get out as a winner. So that's the thing about today's scenario. Now, something about my company, very old organization. We are 125 years old. We are into various businesses, which include cement, tire, pulp, as you can see. Many things we are doing. Annual turnover is more than $2 billion and workforce is more than 25,000 employees. And it's a large organization. As I've told you, very old organization. We started prior to independence. So these were our founder members. How do we get our name, J&K? These are the little things you all must know. Being a civil engineer, you must know Ponsi companies are related. Ponsi unke products. So this whole thing, don't take it ki this is just a blah, blah, blah. This is for your own knowledge. And so you all are fortunate that these things are now available on internet. हमारे टाइम वो भी अवेलेबल नहीं था. सो यू मस्ट एक्सप्लोर नेट इन अ पॉजिटिव मैनर. एंड गोइंग अहेड, दीज वर द टू फाउंडर मेंबर्स, जुगीलाल एंड कमलापत. दिस इज वेयर वी गॉट अवर नेम, जे एंड के. दे वर आवर फाउंडर मेंबर्स इन 1920. ऑर्गेनाइजेशन वाज फाउंडेड एंड लेटर श्री पदमपत सिंघानिया जी टुक ओवर इन 1954. इन 1974 फर्दर बाय श्री गौरवनी सिंघानिया जी अंडर हिज लीडरशिप वी स्टार्टेड अवर सीमेंट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट्स. And Shri Y.P. Singhania ji, he himself was a civil engineer from IIT Roorkee, a very dynamic person. And he took us to many new heights. And we installed many new cement plants under his leadership. We were the first to start white cement in India, JK White, which is a well-known established brand. And many other products, JK Wall Putty, many things we have started. Unfortunately, he left us last year. And today, his nephew, Shri Madhav Singhania ji, he is leading the organization and moving ahead in a very positive manner. He was conferred with many awards. These are few of them. We are in super brand category for our wall putty and white cement. Many awards, as I have told, we have received recently. Now, regarding company, we are a state-of-art producer of white cement and gray cement. Third largest producer of white cement across world, and we do not restrict our boundaries to India only. We have our plant in Dubai also. Now all our plants are following the best possible technology. We are in technical collaboration with FLSmidth. This is a Denmark based company, which is Denmark, friends, you all must know that is the best place for cement technology in world. So this is a company from there who is in technical collaboration with us. So all our plants, all our technology, we are in collaboration with them. We are following all quality standards. This is ISO 9001. This is quality standard. Basically, it's a standard where we put down everything in writing. Whatever we are doing, we have properly documented, and that is being audited both internally and externally. Then we have ISO 14001. This is regarding environment. And all these ISOs, European standards and Indian standards, we are following. We are having robo labs. This is a view of that robo lab. We are everything is automatic. We are following QCX and QXRD. These are basically quality control instruments. And complete operations are fuzzy logic. When I say fuzzy logic, it basically means that if something goes wrong somewhere, say any, if I talk of cement manufacturing, I am manufacturing cement and I fix the fineness, say at 350. It is once fixed in the system. If it goes below that reading, of course, the system will shut down. That is fuzzy logic. So that ensures the quality. And sorry, this is the spread of our plants, friends. Across India, we have been producing cement. We started from Nimbada. This is our first plant, gray cement plant in Rajasthan, then Mangrol again in Rajasthan. Ghotan is a place where we are producing white cement. This was the first white cement plant in India. first in India means first from any company in India. And then we have a grinding unit at Jarli. This is a gray cement unit where we are producing some value-added products also. And then we have a plant in Katni, that is in Madhya Pradesh, where we are producing again value-added products. And this is at Madhol. Madhol is this is for south market. This is a gray cement plant, 3 million ton capacity. We have an international presence in Dubai also, catering many markets. As I have told, it's not company is not restricted only to India. We are giving to many other countries also. Now this is a view of our cement plants, Ghotan, and this is our Dubai plant, and this is Katni. Katni is in MP, where we are producing all value. The two products which I will introduce by the end of this presentation, they are being produced at this plant. They are used for waterproofing. Now friends, everything will be of your interest. My introduction, my company's introduction is over. Now cement and cement industry, because I am from industry, you must be expecting something about cement. Though the topic is waterproofing of structures, still cement plays a very vital role in construction of any structure. Basically, just to start with, I will give you an idea about waterproofing. Why water enters into your structure? Basically, cement is a raw material. It is not a finished product. You take my cement, you add some aggregates into it, you add some admixtures into it, water into it, make a mix. It can be a plaster mix or a RCC mix, and then you put it at the right place and then it dries down. That's the overall thing we do, and the water gets evaporated and there are some pores in it. So that pores, basically that is the entry point of water. You can't have a concrete or a mortar, dried mortar, without any pores. So that is the challenge. That's where the water comes into picture, and once that water enters into structure, it can create a lot of havoc. So that's all we will discuss today. Starting with the cement, this is a bookish definition, friends. You all know there are basically two types of cement, OPC and PPC. So we will just touch upon what it is. It's a dull gray powder, you all think, but it's not like that. There are few good facts about cement. It's the third major revolution after fire and wheel. And this is the third major thing which we have done on earth. Just think of the world without cement. So aapke saath wo computer engineer ya electronics engineers, they must be coming to you and saying that we are superior. Tell them that if there is no building, they cannot sit and do their work. So you are equally important. So it's you should be proud of being a civil engineer, that you are dealing with a material which is so important, which is bringing the third major revolution on the earth. Earlier it was roti kapda aur makan, today it is modern world built with cement. Now cement industry, this was a gentleman who first invented cement at Spin, 21st of October 1824 he did it. And this is the data. I can update it. Actually this pertains to 2015. Today it is more than 3600 million tons. So 3600 million ton of cement per annum is being produced across world. This is a world figure, and China is leading that production at 80, almost 50% of the same, and we are at number 2. Our production last year was 400 metric ton plus. So still there is a huge gap. They are number 1 and we are number 2. So there is a huge gap. Rest of the countries are following us. So a lot of things will come up in India. So you have to be ready for the opportunity. Now this is a view how cement plants, cement technology has shifted. This is the first cement plant in India, Porbandar, Gujarat. This was commissioned in 1949. Today modern plants are something like this. So sorry,
Vikas sir, please if possible slide share view kar lo ji presentation.
Wo na, actually I will do it for you. Just let me know, you can interrupt in between. Actually I think there is some issue with my laptop. The slide doesn't change. Let me know if it change or doesn't. I am making it
okay. Ji, right sir.
Do let me know if it doesn't change.
Right.
So these are all the technological changes, friends, which have taken place. I am not going in detail. We have shifted mainly from OPC to PPC. We have started using many other materials other than the normal traditional material, which can be steel, slag and fly ash, which are being blended into cement. Has the slide changed? Has the slide changed?
Yes, sir.
You are seeing a line diagram?
Yes, sir.
Right. Yeah, fine. Then it's okay. Friends, this is a one line. Now, this is a part of your curriculum also. This is a one line diagram of cement manufacturing. You can very well understand this. You must have studied in your books. Now, taking this into the opportunity, first thing I would like to tell over here that this is a dry process. Earlier, when we started the first cement plant, the process was wet process. When it was wet process, actually we were using liquid like water also as a facilitator to grind your material. But we have totally done away with that practice now. Now everything is in dry process. So how we are doing is, this is a line diagram, you can very well understand. I will explain it briefly. This is your limestone reserve. This is natural stone. This is very high in your calcium oxide. CaO content is normally more than 70%. So that is, it is available abundantly in Himachal and Rajasthan. So that are the places where we have normally cement plants. We do blasting over here. We take out that limestone and then it is fed into this crusher. This is a crushing unit where that material is further brought down to the size of around 40 mm. Because here when we do blasting, the size is very large. So it is brought down to 40 mm in this crusher. Then this is a, you can say, blending yard where we blend this material with, or mixing yard where we blend or mix this material with other materials in a very small quantities. What are those other materials? Those are magnesia, clay, iron oxide. So these are the things which are blended at this place. Now then that is fed into this grinding wheel. Here I have shown a horizontal grinding wheel, but normally plants have vertical grinding wheels. I will show you in actual photographs also. So here everything gets grinded and it gets into powder form. This is that grinding unit. Then it is fed into this from this place. This is a preheater. You can all see that there are various cyclones in it. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 4-stage single string. This is one string only. Sometimes there are two strings also. So this is 4-stage single string preheater. The material will enter from here and then it will fall down under gravity through all this. Now why we have placed all this? Basically, this is the heart of your cement plant, that is kiln. Yahan pe we are firing the coke and the temperature in this kiln is around 1450 degrees centigrade. And that 1450 degrees centigrade is a very high temperature, you all can understand. So whatever gases, whatever exhaust material has been produced in this kiln, it goes out into the atmosphere through this. So what we are doing is, we are feeding the material also through this. So whatever heat is available in this, that helps to preheat my material. So this unit is known as preheater. So here the temperature rises to around 850 degrees centigrade. Then this is a kiln where it gets heated to around 1450 degrees centigrade, material gets melted. Then this is a cooler where everything is brought down to temperature of normally 50 to 60 degrees centigrade, and it takes a spherical shape and the product is known as clinker. So that clinker, now till this place, till production of clinker, whether it is OPC or PPC, the production line is same. Clinker is almost same for all kind of cements. Now here comes the difference between OPC and PPC. You can see these three silos. If you want to produce OPC, you will fill two silos. Basically these three silos, one is for clinker, second one is for gypsum, and third one is for fly ash. So if you want to produce OPC, you all know OPC doesn't have any fly ash. That has been discussed in my previous lectures also. So OPC, basically it is your 95-96% of your clinker, rest is your gypsum only. So if you grind these two, you will get OPC. If you add fly ash also to the tune of 15 to 35% as per standard norms of government, so you will get PPC. Then again the material is grinded and we get cement, which is stored in these silos and it is fed into this market. So this is how we produce cement. One short diagram you can all remember. Now cement we call a magic powder, a highly flexible material. You can take wherever you want, you can cast whatever you want, you can make howsoever strong you want, you can give any shape you want. This I have already discussed with you. Now this is very interesting slide, friends. This gives you a scenario of cement consumption in India and various countries. So this is India's per capita. When I say per capita, per person, how much kg of cement is being used per year. So this is 120 kg in India, China 650 kg, America it is 300, and world's average is 270. You can very well see that we are even less than half of the world's average. So a lot of thing will happen in coming days. We will reach somewhere over here. So a lot of opportunities will be available for all of you, provided you equip yourself with good knowledge. Now, friends, coming to the topic, structural waterproofing. That was all about my basic introduction, my bread and butter product, that is cement, how it is produced. If you have any questions, I will take up in the end of session. Whatever you feel like, you may ask or you may put in your chat box. We'll take one by one. So starting with the today's topic, friends, structural waterproofing. Mota idea I have already given to you, but still, what is the introduction? Structures are normally made of pervious material. So what are the materials you use to make structure? These are it: bricks, blocks, cement, concrete. All these are pervious. All these are porous in nature, and they have tendency to absorb water. So naturally, water will enter into them. You may be using any of the material to join all these material, which is normally cement. Cement is used to join all these materials. Again, a cement mortar is pervious, so water will enter into your structure, and to prevent this entry of water into your structure, you need waterproofing structures. That's the basic reason why do we need to do waterproofing, because whatever material we are using is porous in nature. Now, how I have gone through this entire concept is that I have started right from the start till the end of construction of building, and in between you will get to know how at each step what we have to do to prevent ingress of water into your structure. So I will start right from the foundation, go till finishing, so you will understand. So ingress of water leads to deterioration. You all know if water gets starts entering into your structure, naturally it will lead to a lot of problem. Your steel will get corroded, and once the steel is corroded, it will expand, and there will be a lot of volume increase in steel that will lead to pressure on your concrete. So taking into account all these, we have to ensure that nothing enters into my structures. So water can enter. Let us understand, pani aata kahan se hai building mein? It comes from groundwater first. Aapki jo building hai, normally foundation jo hai wo ground mein rahegi, but ground has water. You all know there is water underneath our ground. Level may be different at different places. At some places very near to you, you all are from Bathinda, a place very near to you, Abhor, Fazilka, there the groundwater is very high, and they have a severe problem of efflorescence and dampness. That is because of groundwater. So that is the first area how you have to take care. Basically, if you provide proper DPC, DPC is nothing but damp proof course, which is provided after your footing level. So if you provide good DPC, that will be taken care of. Seepage through exposed wall is there. Exposed wall, basically external walls of your structure. Water can always enter into that. So you need to have good system. We do have some products which can, when applied on your exteriors, they prevent water ingress into your structure. I will talk about them. Seepage through roof slabs, open roof slabs, jo final slab of the building ki, wahan se pani can always enter into your building. Leakage from concealed water pipes, rainwater pipes. So this is another area. Aap jo water pipe apne structure mein use kar rahe hain, conduits jise aap kehte hain, to carry water from various places. From it starts right from the main pipe to your meter, further into your kitchen, bathroom, everything. So those, there can be leakages in that. Seepage through parapet joints. Parapet is a small wall which is normally constructed over your roof slab, jise aap chhaja kehte hain. So for that, there is a joint between that wall and your RCC slab, which is the weakest point from where water enters. Seepage through joints of window frames. It can be wooden frames or steel frames, so water can enter it through them. Seepage through upper floor bathroom, sunken areas. That is very severe problem. If it happens, you need to rectify it by dismantling everything. We'll take up everything in detail. So in order to make the structure watertight, we have to take preventive measure at each step, right from foundation till glazing I have gone. in one slide I have shown you the all the it is not that ki building ban gayi baad mein main waterproofing kar lunga, it's not nothing like that. You have to go do waterproofing at each step, right from footing till finishing. Now, how to prevent water to enter into my structure? That's the biggest challenge. To make my structure waterproof, basically water should not enter into my structure. So I am starting right away from the basement. मतलब suppose कर लीजिए आपकी construction ऐसा है जिसमें आप एक basement बना रहे हैं, so naturally सबसे पहले basement ही बनेगी. या अगर basement नहीं है तो footing होगी. So we will take up both the cases. If you are constructing a basement of your dream home, you need to have extra precautions because basement is a area which throughout its life it will remain under earth. So this is a area, this is a place which needs extra attention with respect to waterproofing. So what extra prevention we have to take? First thing is that whatever you are constructing, if you are going in for basement, whatever you are constructing below your ground level, it has to be in RCC. It should not be in brickwork. I have seen places where people are doing brickwork for basements. That is totally wrong practice. You have to do it with RCC, and that too with the rich mortar. The minimum M20 grade nominal mix is 1.53, which we have to use for it. Now we must lay base slab with a proper design of steel and using a good quality liquid integral waterproofing. See, basement ka jo base hai, jise aap floor keh sakte ho basement ka, that normally is, I have seen some places where they wanted to construct a basement, they have just casted their side walls. Floor unhone normal practice ki tarah uske upar jaise aap normal flooring karte ho ground floor ki us tarah kar di. That is wrong. If you are going in for basement, because you are going closer to the groundwater level, so for that you need to have proper base slab, and that has to be designed using proper steel and good quality integral waterproofing about. So naturally, to avoid water to come, there is a tendency to of groundwater come upwards within your basement. To avoid that, we are doing this. The same waterproofing compound is recommended for vertical casting. A base ban gaya. उसके बाद जो वर्टिकल वॉल्स बन रही है आपकी बेसमेंट की, फॉर ऑल दोस यू नीड टू हैव गुड क्वालिटी इंटेग्रल वाटरप्रूफिंग कंपाउंड. व्हाई आई एम सेइंग इंटेग्रल, इट इज बीइंग एडेड इनटू योर मिक्स. व्हाइल यू आर मेकिंग द मिक्स ऑफ योर कंक्रीट, यू आर एडिंग दिस वाटरप्रूफिंग कंपाउंड. सो इट हैज टू बी इंटेग्रल ओनली. एंड फर्दर टू इंटेग्रल, आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर, देयर आर मेनी थिंग्स व्हिच आर नॉट देयर इन द पीपीटी, सो यू हैव टू लिसन मी प्रॉपरली. सो इंटेग्रल वाटरप्रूफिंग कंपाउंड बेसिकली इट हैज टू बी लिक्विड ओनली. There are powders also available in the market. They have the challenge of mixing. So we should always use liquid waterproofing compound. It has to be added to water first, and then that water is added into your mix, concrete mix. So that's that has been proper dispersion of this material, and that will give you a good waterproofing effect. While casting the side walls, proper use of vibrator is very important. Now, this is what is vibrator. Basically, it is a mechanical arrangement which helps to get rid of my air voids in concrete. So if you, basically as I have told in the beginning, water will enter through voids only. So vibrator is very important if you are casting your vertical wall of your basement or base of your basement. The concrete has to be compacted thoroughly with a vibrator. Water cement ratio has to be monitored closely. This is very important. जितना आपको नॉर्मली वाटर सीमेंट रेशियो यू मस्ट हैव स्टडीड इट, इट हैज टू बी 0.3-0.4 मैक्सिमम, बट नॉर्मल मिक्स में हम डालते हैं 0.6, समथिंग इवन मोर देन दैट. सो दैट एक्स्ट्रा वाटर व्हेन इट एवेपोरेट्स, इट इनवाइट्स वाटर टू एंटर इनटू योर स्ट्रक्चर थ्रू पोर्स. सो दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू टेक केयर ऑफ योर वाटर सीमेंट रेशियो. स्पेशल केयर हैज टू बी टेकन केयर फॉर कोल्ड जॉइंट्स ऑफ कंक्रीट. नो वाटर कोल्ड जॉइंट्स, आप जब कंक्रीटिंग करते हैं, some structure is casted today, another part is being casted next day, so there is a joint between old concrete and new concrete, so that is the weakest point from where water can enter. There we need proper polymer for bonding of old and new concrete. So this is very important. Normally nobody follows this, but this is important. Always go in for vertical waterproofing membranes from exterior of base. Once you have casted your basement, now this is always about basement. So, uske bahar, before refilling the earth जो साइड पे वॉल्स हैं उसके साइड पे आप अर्थ फिलिंग करते हो बाद में, बिफोर दैट यू हैव टू अप्लाई वर्टिकल वाटरप्रूफिंग मेम्ब्रेन. दिस कैन बी बिटमन कोटिंग्स और पॉलीमर कोटिंग्स, दिस आर अवेलेबल. बिटमन इज द ट्रेडिशनल प्रोडक्ट विच वी हैव बीन यूजिंग फॉर मेनी ईयर्स, गांव में आज भी यूज होता होगा. बट इफ एक टॉक ऑफ ए क्लास सिटीज, देयर आर पॉलीमर कोटिंग्स अवेलेबल फ्रॉम मेनी कंपनीज विच आर अप्लाइड विद द हेल्प ऑफ ब्रश. Normally they are mixed with, there are some coatings which are two component, there is cement and polymer. You have to mix it in a proper proportion. Normally it is 2:1 and apply it with the help of brush on the exterior of your RCC surface to make it watertight, or else you can go in for bitumen. Now if you go in for bitumen, you have to apply a coat of primer first. That is very important because it doesn't get sticky to your RCC surface. So a primer coat followed by bitumen. Now grade of bitumen used for this purpose is 85-25. You should not go in for a bitumen which is being used for your road work. That is normally 80-100. That is very soft. Whereas for this purpose, for we are using 85-25, which once gets set, it forms a brittle layer. So that is important. 85-25 you should remember. Waterproofing purpose, bitumen should be minimum 85-25 grade. Now, if you are not constructing basement, the other way around is that you are doing a normal brickwork foundation, and after that, before starting your superstructure, anything which is below your ground is substructure, anything above ground is superstructure. So in between we have a course, that is DPC. Now this is a case where I don't have a basement, but if I want to construct a structure with normal footing, it will be normally of brickwork only. These days people prefer framed structures also, but in between there are brick walls. So that is the way. Once you reach up to your ground level, after that we prefer giving 9 inches beam instead of normally jo DPC dalti hai na, aapne agar site pe kahin dekha ho, to they what they do is they use a thick concrete of 1-1.5 inch, ek patta sa bana lete hain over your bricks and they say ki hamara DPC ho gaya. Just think that will it take care of your groundwater coming from the earth? It won't. So wo pani aayega, ye 1.5 inch ka jo patta wo crack ho jata. So normally that's the reason we recommend 9 inches beam at this level. It is just below your plinth level, below DPC level. हम एक पूरा 9 inches का बीम बना देंगे पूरे स्ट्रक्चर को टाई है. नाउ इट विल हैव टू पर्पसेस. द फर्स्ट इज वाटरप्रूफिंग ऑफ कोर्स, क्योंकि ये 9 inch बीम है, इट्स अ थिक बीम. इसके अंदर नेचुरली मैं कंपैक्टेड कंक्रीट यूज करूंगा, वाटरप्रूफिंग कंपाउंड डालूंगा, तो इट वॉन्ट अलाउ वाटर टू कम अप. एंड फर्दर इट विल ऑल्सो गिव मी अ इफेक्ट ऑफ प्रिवेंशन फ्रॉम अर्थक्वेक्स, बिकॉज इट विल एक्ट एज अ टाई बीम एट दैट लेवल. नॉर्मली वी गिव टाई बीम एट स्लैब लेवल. So this is another type beam. If you give at foundation level, it will give you dual purpose. And the rest of the thing is same. DPC rich concrete has to be used, and the mix of DPC should be properly compacted. The type beam at plinth level shall be compacted well with the vibrator. So that is a must. कई बार देखा कि beam डाल भी रहे हैं, but उसके लिए they are using shuttering. वो normally बठिंडा साइड पे बहुत ज़्यादा they are using wooden shuttering, तो उसके अंदर vibrator नहीं चल पाएगा. You have to go in for steel shuttering so that you can use vibrator, mechanical vibrator, needle vibrator for proper compaction. Now that is the area. Step by step we are going till foundation. These were the two cases which we have discussed. DPC is important, and you, if at all basement you are doing, so all those things were important. After that you do normal your brickwork. No waterproofing is required in brickwork. You should use normal cement, good quality cement. The only thing is you should keep water cement ratio in control. And once you have done your brickwork, you come to the stage that is slab. Now here when I refer to slab, this is a final slab. Naturally you want to cast first slab. This is exposed slab what I am talking of, jahan se pani enter kar sakta. Naturally agar do floor bana rahe ho, to this is about second floor slab. Now for this again we have to use good quality waterproofing compound. Slab casting jab aapne karni hai, minimum grade should be M20. Plate shuttering has to be used with vibrator. Concrete in itself is porous in nature and needs extra treatment to make it waterproof, which can be done ये नहीं है कि मैंने ये सब कर लिया, M20 डाल लिया, वाटरप्रूफिंग कंपाउंड डाल लिया. इवन देन इफ इट इज एक्सपोज स्लैब यू हैव टू अप्लाई सम कोटिंग ओवर इट. ट्रेडिशनल मेथड इज बिटुमन कोटिंग. टुडे पीपल आर गोइंग इन फॉर पॉलीमर कोटिंग ऑल्सो. नाउ आफ्टर ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ डक्टाइल सॉरी मड फस्का, दिस इज अ ट्रेडिशनल मेथड जिसे हम कहते हैं ना. This is nothing but your mud fusca. What they do over here is, this is the pictorial diagram. You can very well understand from this diagram. This is your parapet wall. This is your wall. Normal जो structure आपने बनाया था नीचे. This is one of the wall. ये उसके ऊपर मैंने slab cast की. This is your slab. You can very well see. And this is my parapet wall. Parapet is normally 3-3.5 feet wall, which is normally given over your this thing. And now see how this is a traditional method जिससे हम waterproofing करते हैं. This is your bitumen layer. Of course, before giving bitumen, you will have to give a coat of primer. It is again a bitumen primer which you apply with the help of brush. After that, a coat of bitumen. Then this is mud fusca. This thicker layer is of mud fusca. This is mud fusca, and basically this acts as a waterproofing as well as insulation agent also. Waterproofing is being done by the lower layer, your bitumen, or your, it can be bitumen or it can be your polymer coating also. There are two component polymer coatings also, so that can also be applied over that mud fusca, and then these are brick tiles, and then we do pointing of these brick tiles at the joint with the help of rich cement mortar. So this is the system which we normally follow. And if you see this system, the weakest point now after doing all this from where water can enter is this point only. We have to take care of this point. I will tell you in detail how we take care of, because this is a place from normally this will have some slope. Here we will have some rainwater pipes also. So water will come near to the wall, and once it come near to the wall, it will try to enter into your structure from this point. So we'll take care of this also. I will tell you how. See, this is how we apply now this all blackish layer. They have already applied primer coat, and on that now this is felt. This is not bitumen coating. Here they are using tar felt. This is a bituminous felt which is available in the market, and this is normally polymer based also. So this is coming in roll. This is 1 meter by 20 meter roll. Normally they are available. These are the roll lying over here. First, they have applied a coat of primer. After that, they are laying this with the help of torch. एक टॉर्च होती है, उससे इसको हीट करेंगे तो वो अपने आप मेल्ट होता जाता है और इसके ऊपर वो स्टिक कर जाता. So this is one way of doing waterproofing at your slab. This is another way, polymeric waterproofing. This is a high tech product. Basically, polymers are available. They are mixed with your cementitious compound. They can be applied with the help of brush or a spray gun. Here he is applying with the help of spray gun. So this is how they can do. And this is of course a high tech product. Isme fayda kya hai ki if you are doing it with spray gun, this will isme kya hai, they are making a layer over it. It is not penetrating much into your pores of your slab, whereas when this is being applied with pressure, this will actually move seal the pores. So this is much more effective. Now over that, I have told you we will lay some tiles after after putting the tile mud fusca. So after doing this layer, either this or this, I have put some mud which is not visible over here, and after that I have laid these brick tiles. These are available in market, and these brick tiles, then I do a good quality pointing over here. This is very important. Ultimately pani iske upar girna hai, तो इससे पानी अंदर जा ही ना. द बेस्ट थिंग यू शुड रिमेंबर अबाउट वाटर प्रूफिंग इज दैट वी हैव टू कंट्रोल वाटर एट द एंट्री पॉइंट. जब वो पानी एंटर कर रहा है आपके स्ट्रक्चर में, जितनी जल्दी उसे रोक लोगे उतना बढ़िया. व्हाई आई एम सेइंग दिस इज, दिस इज द एंट्री पॉइंट. रेन विल फॉल ओवर हियर. इफ यू कैन सील दिस वेल, दिस इज द एंट्री पॉइंट. अगर ये फेल होगा तो अंदर जाएगा, फिर वो मड फंसेगा, फिर वो कोटिंग सब काम करेगा, बट बेटर वी कंट्रोल इट फ्रॉम हियर ओनली. सो दैट इज अ थंब रूल. And for that, proper slope is very important. While laying your these brick tiles, you should have proper slope so that no water. See, if water comes on your slab and it moves away, it's a flowing water. It won't lead to any waterproofing problem. Only the stagnant water will enter into your structure, and the water will be stagnant only if there is a problem of slope. So you have to take care that slope is proper on your, and there are I will share with you, there are guidelines for SOHO. That is, these are like this. Now we have to give rainwater pipes. Now the spacing between the outlet pipe should not be more than 6 meters in any case. Basically, this all depends upon how much discharge, this depends upon how much area is there, how much is the area of slab, and what is the quantity we are building. Jahan pe aap building bana rahe hain, us area mein rainfall kitni hai. This is see. इसमें उन्होंने क्लियरली दिया कि दिस इज द चार्ट यू विल यूज टू 6 मीटर इज द स्पेसिंग. नाउ हाउ विल यू डिसाइड कितने डायमीटर का रेन वाटर पाइप रखना है. दीज आर द डायमीटर्स. दिस इज द एरिया ऑफ योर स्लैब 50 स्क्वायर मीटर 7500. सो दिस इज अ रेफरेंस फ्रॉम यूर कोड ओनली. एंड दिस इज द एवरेज रेनफॉल इन mm पर आवर. दिस डेटा इज अवेलेबल इन मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट. आपने जहां भी बिल्डिंग बनानी है वहां का आपको ये एरिया का मिल जाएगा कि उस एरिया में रेन कितनी है. देन यू हैव टू सी आपका एरिया कितना है स्लैब का, एंड अकॉर्डिंगली यू विल सी कि मेरा डायमीटर ऑफ द रेन वाटर पाइप क्या रहेगा. तो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू फिक्स. ये ना हो कि मुझे डिस्चार्ज ज्यादा था, रेन वाटर पाइप का डायमीटर ज्यादा चाहिए था, बट मैंने वहां पे पाइप स्मॉल यूज कर ली, तो दैट विल लीड टू स्टेग्नेशन ऑफ वाटर. वो एकदम से निकल नहीं पाएगा, दैट विल लीड टू प्रॉब्लम. नाउ कमिंग फर्दर टू पैरापेट वॉल. पैरापेट वॉल डिटेलिंग एट जंक्शन ऑफ रूफ इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. बेसिकली वो जो मैंने आपको पहले भी दिखाया था, दिस इज इट अगेन एक्सप्लेनिंग द सेम थिंग. दिस इज अ डिटेल्ड थिंग ऑफ दिस थिंग ओनली. बेसिक थिंग इज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट दिस इज द वीकेस्ट पॉइंट फ्रॉम वेयर वाटर विल एंटर इनटू योर स्ट्रक्चर. टू सील दिस पॉइंट दिस काइंड ऑफ अरेंजमेंट इज अ मस्ट. ये स्लैब तो पहले कास्ट हो गई, बाद में ये वॉल बनी, तो ये फिलेट बाद में एक बनेगा यहाँ पे. नॉर्मली इसे देसी भाषा में वो गोला या गलता कह देते हैं. दिस इज फिलेट, कंक्रीट फिलेट. बेसिकली यू हैव टू मेक इट विद द रिच कंक्रीट, एंड हेयर इट इज शोन लाइक दिस. इफ यू कैन मेक लाइक दिस इट्स ओके. नॉर्मली दे मेक इट इन अ कर्व्ड मैनर लाइक दिस. सो इफ इट इज लाइक दिस इट इज ओके. सम पीपल मेक इट लाइक दिस, इट इज रॉन्ग. If you are making it like this, what you are doing is you are just transferring the problem from this point to this point. आपने यहाँ पे इतना बड़ा गोला बना दिया, वो पानी यहाँ आना था, यहाँ की बजाय यहाँ से एंटर करना शुरू कर दिया. But if it is best is curved structure like this, concave. So उससे क्या होगा कि जो पानी यहाँ आएगा ये उसे repel करेगा. Even this is okay, जो यहाँ पे show किया गया fillet, this will repel the water. This won't allow the water to come near to this joint and whatever coating, this has to be done directly over your concrete. Whatever coating you are doing, it will then go up over here, sorry, and then it will go up onto the wall also and plugged over here. This is the right manner. Normally क्या करते हैं लोग, ये बनाते नहीं है, जो आपने coating की उसको यहीं छोड़ दिया तो कुछ नहीं हुआ, ये आपका weak point बन गया, यहाँ से पानी अंदर जाएगा. So you have to do it like this. Fillet, this coating going up to the wall, then plugging over here in a proper manner. This is the right way for treating your parapet walls. This is the same thing I have told you that you should use galta in not gola. So galta is something like this which will repel the water. Now another area which is very prone to your water entry into your structure is expansion joints. You all are civil engineers, you must have studied expansion joints in your structural designs. Why do we get structural designs? You all know, because there is expansion and contraction of your buildings. Of course this is given in a very big buildings, not small structures. These are there in your bridges also. So those expansion joints need to be expansion joint, as you know, it is a basically a hollow space given between two members to allow expansion and contraction of those members. Now that hollow space is okay, that was required structurally, but that will allow water to enter. See, these are your two structures. ये continuous slab चल रही थी यहाँ से, say it's an industrial shed. अब यहाँ पे आपने एक gap दे दिया. This is nothing but your expansion joint. Now, but you need to seal it very properly, and this is the arrangement we recommend for sealing of your expansion joint. इसमें कुछ नहीं है, ये यहाँ से तो ये joint खाली है. We normally fill it with thermocol, then we put a plate over here. Metallic plate is placed over at this level. Then we put some bituminous compound or a filler or a it is normally a ceiling compound. There are various kind of ceiling compound available. Earlier people were using bituminous ceiling compound. वो आज भी आती हैं, बहुत से compound आते हैं. They are caulking compounds only. But आज की date में जो latest technology है, that is polysulfide. Polysulfides are being used to fill. They are the material. They come in liquid shape. They are normally in two component. You have to mix the two component. You put it over here. They will get set and they will take a rubber shape of thing. They will have very good adhesion with your concrete or brick walls. And after it will, since it will form a rubber like thing, so expansion is allowed. So that is the material polysulfide. You may know down. These are available from various companies to fill your expansion units. And once you have made all this arrangement, again you have to do this kind of extension work so that water doesn't come directly into it. So they have made a extra structure for this to cover up your expansion unit. It can be in your RCC or brickwork. So whatever coating you were doing over here, it has gone right from here to here to here. The entire thing has been covered so that they have not taken a single chance of entry of water into this expansion unit. Requirement of good waterproofing system, it should be impermeable. Now whatever system, it can be a polymeric layer, it can be a bituminous layer, it can be anything. Basic requirements are it should be impermeable, it should have strong adhesion with the substrate, it should have sufficient elasticity because it will be exposed to atmosphere, expansion contraction rahegi, so it has to be elastic in nature. It should have high resistance to abrasion and cracking. It should have resistance to ultraviolet rays. It should be breathable. That is very important. Air should pass through it to permit vapor transmissions. Application should be easy and it should be durable. Now, prevalent waterproofing system, jo bhi aajkal available hai, bahut pehle hum use karte the lime concrete terracing. Ye abhi aajkal nahi use ho raha. Mud fuska, I have already explained to you. Waterproofing using polythene films or felts, which I have shown in a photograph also. Then there are polymer coating, wo jo humne pehle coating aapko dikhai thi. Modified bitumen membranes are also available. Waterproofing using bitumen felts is there. Epoxy coatings are also there. This is a high-end product, very costly but very effective also. Then there are the best one, why I have kept in writing, the best thing is you can avoid all this, you can minimize the use of all this by using integral waterproofing compound during construction. This has to be added during construction. Once you have done this, 80% of the thing is over, rest you can take care. But if you have not used this, then the problem will be severe. Now other area, friends, where water, I have told in the beginning, pani jo aapki building mein aayega, that is through sunken areas. Now this is a sunken slab. Basically what is a sunken slab? Aapne jab first floor pe aapne construction karni hai, to jitna bhi aapka washroom area, wo thoda slab jo hai depressed rakha jata. To take care of your fittings and all pipes, everything. So this depressed area is the most you can say exposed area jahan se aapke lower slab mein pani enter karega. Reason is very clear, because bathroom ke upar bathroom banna hai, yahan pe bathroom bhi banna hai, and this area will be basically exposed to water. So bathroom means har time aave pani rahega, to usko avoid karne ke liye special treatment is required. Here they have given, you can see this coating. Here they have given polymeric coating. This can be any, there are many available, like Pidilite ki Pidifin 2 ki aati hai. Both the coatings available hai, two component coatings available hai. Normally they are one part of powder, two part of powder, one part of liquid. And liquid is nothing but a polymer, and powder is normally a cementitious material. And they apply it with the help of brush in two coats. And this basically seals all the pores. So this is a special treatment required for your sunken areas. Now see, this is a overall view how we have to do your washrooms. Now this is that any fittings or anything, this has gone into your sunken area. This is the below the floor is your sunken area. This is how they have done. This is the common pipe running between the floors. They have jointed all the things with it. This is the trap for your wash basin. This is a trap for your WC, and this is a normal gully, and they have connected all these in this sunken area. We had earlier shown this area, waterproofing of this area, and this is the way we have to do. leakage from concealed pipes or rainwater pipe, this is very common. You just need to check that this doesn't happen. Normally pipe doesn't, there are very few chances that pipe fails in the center of the span. Normally it is the joint which fails. So you have to take good care of joint, and for joints we should use good quality sealants. Like silicone sealants are available nowadays, PVC sealants, rubber gaskets, these all things are available in market, and we should use them in a proper manner. Now seepage through exposed wall, friend, exterior wall jitne bhi aapke usme se bhi pani aata, to uske liye the first thing, if it is a brick wall, you have to do the pointing very minutely. Pointing is jise aap local language mein tip keh dete hain. After brick work, they do a very fine quality work, which is pointing. It is not a fine aesthetic work only. You have to, basically you are taking care of water to enter into your structure. The front and back fill of the building should be either plastered, aise nahi exposed, jo aapki side wall hai, front wall hai, ya back wall hai, it should be plastered. You should not leave it as such. And there are various types. Sometimes people are going in for tiles also. आजकल एक्सटीरियर पे एक बहुत अच्छी ब्रिक टाइल्स लगती हैं। आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग ऑफ सिरेमिक टाइल्स, वो तो वाटरप्रूफ होती हैं। बट इफ यू आर यूजिंग ब्रिक टाइल्स, देन यू हैव टू गिव अ सिलिकॉन कोटिंग ओवर इट टू प्रिवेंट। दिस इज नॉर्मली सिलिकॉन कोटिंग इज अवेलेबल फ्रॉम वेरियस कंपनीज। इट इज ट्रांसपेरेंट, यू जस्ट हैव टू अप्लाई इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ ब्रश एंड इट फॉर्म्स अ इनविजिबल लेयर, यू कैन से अ काइंड ऑफ lamination is done over your building, and that doesn't allow water to enter into your structure. Seepage through upper floor bathroom, this I've already explained. I've shown you how to do that. It can be done with the we have shown polymer based bitumen coatings can also be used over there. Seepage through joints of window frames, now this is another area where water can enter. For that, those we have special sealants available with us. Acrylic sealants are available, and for aluminium glazings we have silicone sealants, so accordingly we have to use. Now how to do my if the structure is there and there is some problem. Till now whatever I have talked about, it was about construction of new building. Suppose aapki building already bani hui hai, usme koi problem aa jati hai, to what are the reason and how to rectify. Small table I have shared over here. That up to 2 to 3 meter, अगर आपके फ्लोर में से डैम्पनेस आ रही है, which is normally a failure of your DPC, there you have to create a artificial DPC. That's one of the treatment. You have to take down all the plaster and you have to cut a groove of around 2.5 inches into the wall if it is a 9 inches wall, and then you have to refill some material that is rich RCC material into that wall with some integral waterproofing compound. And then redo the plaster using some good quality integral waterproofing compound. Seepage from ceiling, proper treatment has to be done. You should consult the expert, as I have explained earlier also. Seepage through on walls adjacent to bathroom, you have to thoroughly check all the pipes. It has to be done with the plumber so that there is no leakage. Seepage from ceiling, proper treatment of room has to be done, as I have explained. Now friends, that was all about waterproofing. I will explain two or three of my products, not taking much of time. I think we are on time. We have taken 1 hour only till now. Another 20 minutes I will take and explain you that there are some products which can really help you to take care of your waterproofing needs. So basically, why we have formulated these products, just very quickly I can tell you. Basically, aap pehle kya karte the, there was only one cement. आप एक ही सीमेंट था, उससे ही आप टाइल फिक्स कर लेते थे, उसी से ही आप प्लास्टर कर लेते थे। आज की डेट में ब्रिक्स की जगह पीपल आर यूजिंग ब्लॉक्स, एसी ब्लॉक्स आ गए हैं। इवन फॉर ब्लॉक्स पीपल आर यूजिंग द सेम सीमेंट, सो दैट इज नॉट द राइट कंसेप्ट। यू शुड यूज प्रॉपर जॉइंटिंग मोर्टार फॉर लेइंग ऑफ ब्लॉक्स, यू शुड यूज प्रॉपर प्लास्टरिंग मटीरियल फॉर प्लास्टरिंग, यू शुड यूज प्रॉपर मटीरियल फॉर वाटर प्रूफिंग मेम्ब्रेन। सो नॉट द सेम सीमेंट विल वर्क एवरीवेयर, टेकिंग दैट इन टू अकाउंट। Basically, these are the four needs where we have to work. We need to have quick construction. Earlier, ek building banti thi, kuch saalon mein banti thi. Abhi, the requirement is it has to be completed within couple of weeks. So whatever we give to the market, the first need is that it should it should be such a material so that we can speed up our construction. Second is durability. Whatever we should give, it should last for a longer period. ease of application is very important, because ultimately all my products are being applied by a layman mason. So उसके लिए जो भी product हम बनाएं वो लगाना आसान हो, mixing आसान हो, ऐसा ना हो कि उसके component इतने या नापना ही मुश्किल हो जाए उसके लिए. Then value for money, the customer who is giving me money, he should get a good product. Keeping all this in mind, we have formulated many products. So I am just touching 2 to 3 of them. Basically, friends, this is my shield bags. Now this is a water, as the word says, universal waterproof putty. Now you all are aware of what putty is. Putty is a material. Basically, it's a skim coat which we normally apply on plastered surface before painting to give it a smooth, silky finish. So we were the leader to produce this product in India. As on date, we are the world leaders for this product as far as skim coat or wall putty is concerned. Now this is a normal, very good wall putty area that is under the name of JK Cement Wall Max. But this product is something better than that. This is having a waterproofing quality also. We call it as Shield Max. This we recommend for interior and exterior both. So this is coming in 20 kg pack. And basically what we have added into it is we have added sealant over normal putty. This is something extra in this. This sealant will form a highly integrated molecular gel in this putty, and that won't allow water to penetrate through it. Both ek integrated na gel ban jata andar iske, and that basically makes it watertight. I won't say it's a waterproof thing. It's not a solution, waterproofing solution. It is a better waterproof, having good water resistance than normal putty. अगर आपका ऑलरेडी कोई पाइप लीक कर रहा है, कोई स्ट्रक्चर में प्रॉब्लम है, देन दिस इज नॉट द सॉल्यूशन, बिकॉज दिस इज अ पुटी, दिस विल बी नॉर्मली अप्लाइड इन 2 to 3 mm. सो दैट वॉन्ट सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम. दिस इज अ एडिशनल थिंग. अगर आपने एक यू हैव मेड द स्ट्रक्चर ब्यूटीफुली एंड यू हैव टेकन केयर ऑफ एवरीथिंग, देन बिफोर गोइंग इन फॉर पेंटिंग यू शुड यूज दिस वाटर प्रूफ पुटी इंस्टेड ऑफ नॉर्मल पुटी. दिस विल टेक केयर ऑफ योर नॉर्मल मॉइस्चर विच इज कमिंग इन वॉल. सो दैट इज द प्रोडक्ट. And as I've told you, external, internal, both the walls can be, it can be used, new walls and old walls, it can be used. That's why we called it universal waterproof putty. It's very easy to apply, and this is the way we do it. You just have to clean the surface and remove any dirt, grease available onto the surface, make a paste, adding around 35% water into it, and make a thick paste, and then you can apply it with the help of normal tools. This is how we do it. Surface cleaning is important. If there is any dirt, grease over your plastered surface, that has to be removed, because this is a cement based product and it will have good bonding with cement only. Now these are the normal tools used to apply, very simple things. This is a mechanical stirrer, this is a normal mixing pot, and this is normally a putty blade with the help of which we apply this. How to apply? You just have to clean the surface, and sanding has to be done. Just scribe out whatever extra material is there, and then you have to make the mix using 38 to 40% of water, as I have told you. Mixing tool should be clean, and then the one thing is very important. After adding water, you should wait for around 5 minutes. After mixing, even you should wait for 5 minutes before application. The reason is that is a gestation period for these polymers to get active, and once that polymers get active, they will give you a better flexibility. This material should be highly flexible, so that flexibility is attained by adding polymers into it, and they get activated. They need some time, so you should not start working just after addition of water. Wait for some time. And this is how we apply. Here we have shown a trowel. It can be a putty blade normal also. And coverage, I would like to highlight over here, this is not only about waterproofing. Shield Max is having a better coverage than your normal putty also, and more whiteness also. So here the coverage is around 20 square feet per kg in 2 coats, whereas your normal putty gets around 14 square feet per kg. So these are the advantages, friends, of this product from our side. Damp resistance, efflorescence. What is efflorescence? It is basically salt coming out of your walls. What is the carrier of that salt? It is basically water. So basically these two things are related, efflorescence and dampness. Agar walls mein se pani bahar nahi aa raha to salt bhi nahi aa sakta. That salt is coming, the carrier is water only. So these are related problems only, and this product will take care. It will give you a longer paint life, and it's suitable for all kind of wounds. And the next thing which I would like to share with you is a unique product which has been launched by JK Cement in recently. That's a cement based primer. Friends, suppose this is a plastered surface you have slide mein dekh rahe hain, and you want to paint it. Normal traditional method aaj tak kya raha ki iske upar ek pehle primer lagaya jata hai, which is coming from paint companies. They are giving primers just like wood primer, steel primer. They are giving cement primer also, jisko wo cement primer ke naam se use word karte hain, just because it is being applied on cement. It has nothing to do with cement. It doesn't have cement in it. It is a acrylic primer. Basically they call it as cement primer. Your painter will tell you to bring that cement primer. Aap jaoge to wahan milega aapko acrylic primer. Wo acrylic primer la ke aap iske upar ek coating kar dete hain. Now what does that coating do? Basically it laminates this wall so that it becomes smooth, and uske upar aap paint kar dete hain. And होता क्या, लेमिनेशन जब मैं करूंगा आई विल शो यू. नाउ इफ यू लुक इनटू दिस वॉल इन अ माइक्रोस्कोपिक व्यू, दिस इज समथिंग लाइक दिस. अब मैं अगर इसके ऊपर एक पॉलीथीन की शीट बिछा दूं, विच इज माय एक्रेलिक प्राइमर, और उसके ऊपर पेंट कर दूं, तो मैं बेसिकली क्या कर रहा हूं, मैं पेंट कर रहा हूं सिर्फ एक पॉलीथीन की शीट. द मूवमेंट उस पॉलीथीन की शीट की लाइफ गई तो ये क्रैक हो जाएगा मेरा पेंट सारा. यू कैन जस्ट इमेजिन कि इसके ऊपर मैंने एक पॉलीथीन की शीट रख के पेंट कर दिया. Whereas my product, it will actually move into these pores. It will actually seal all those pores and it will make it smooth, and then you will do a paint. Naturally, usme life jada aayegi. This is it. This you can see. This is, we shouldn't use the name, sorry. And this is a plastered surface. This is their primer, acrylic primer, and this is my product. You can see the difference very well. Naturally, iske upar jab paint karoge life jada hogi. So this is a product, friends. It is breathable. And this is a packing. This is very much available in each part of your wherever you are, entire country we are covering. So this is dekhne mein ye bucket hai. In fact, this is in powder form. We have two packs in it. This is a 10 kg bucket. Two packs of 5 kg are there. Bucket intentionally we have given because this is really applied by a painter. He requires a bucket to make a mix. So that's why this packing is there. And see. Why DK Primex? Because it has got good adhesion. Cement based product hai, cement to cement adhesion jyada rahegi. It will fill the pores, it will improve the adhesion of paint, it will impart strength and durability to your substrate, make the substrate less absorbent, that is waterproofing only. It will seal the cracks, basically not allow water to enter into your. It will reduce construction cost also naturally, because it will save on time also. I will tell you how, and it is economical. Now these are the benefits: smooth surface for painting and improving coverage, improved durability, and improved bonding to the base coat, and reduced paint consumption. High water permeability is there. See the finish. For all the advantages, I'm moving fast so that you can just have an idea. Now this product, friends, this can be applied on wet plaster also, and there is no need of curing even after doing. Suppose आपकी ये building है, इसके ऊपर आपने scaffolding लगा के plastering की. Using the same scaffolding, you can apply this Primex over it, and you will save on cost. That's why we say it's economical also. See, these are the kind of problem if you don't use good quality of primer. This kind of blistering will be there. So good quality primer is important. That's what we are. Very easy to apply. Surface preparation, again, there should be no foreign material. 50% water has to be added. Need the mix for 1 minute, and then another 50% water. The total mix is 1:1. If you are applying it with the spray gun, then you can increase the water also. And application has to be done within 2 to 3 hours of making the mix. And coverage is approximately 100 square feet. These are the technical specifications. Can be applied with brush. I'm just sharing some of the areas where it has been applied. These are the actual photographs of the project done by us. This is in Mohali only. See this basement area. Being a civil engineer, you all know this basement is normally a parking. So we need an economical solution. This is only 1 rupee square feet coating. So very good option instead of going in for normal. वो वहाँ पे lime wash करते हैं. So this is a good option for your basements, for your side walls. See, Now this is our school being built, and we have done this area on plaster. As I have told you, this can be done on green plaster also. Green means wet plaster using the same scaffolding. They have saved the cost of, see, using the same scaffolding they are moving at, and the entire building was done. This is in Panchkula only. Sidewalls, many areas we have done, just running fast. This was a building where they wanted to put glass cladding. So they have done a blue color over it, and then they have put a glass over it. So many areas we have done. This is a school building only. Sorry. This is being done with roller, same product. And the last thing which I would discuss again from waterproofing angle is tile adhesive. Friend, you have been using cement for fixing of your tile. Normally क्या होता है जब आपने टाइल फिक्स करनी है, चाहे वो फ्लोर टाइल है, वॉल टाइल है, एक्सटीरियर है, इंटीरियर है, वी नॉर्मली यूज सीमेंट फॉर पेस्टिंग ऑफ टाइल, विच इज अ रॉन्ग प्रैक्टिस. व्हाई? द मेजर रीजन इज दैट द सीमेंट विच यू आर यूजिंग फॉर पेस्टिंग ऑफ टाइल दैट डजंट गेट अ अपॉर्चुनिटी टू गेट क्योर्ड. और अगर सीमेंट की क्योरिंग नहीं होगी तो उसमें ताकत आएगी नहीं. दैट्स व्हाई बिकॉज ऑफ श्रिंकेज इट लीव्स एंड योर टाइल्स फॉल डाउन. सो दिस इज अ मटीरियल विच हैज सेल्फ क्योरिंग प्रॉपर्टी. So we have made various grades. I am just running fast. I am just tell basically adhesive ka purpose kya hai? To wet the surface, to adhere with the surface, to develop strength after laying, and to remain durable and stable. Tile adhesive is a adhesive used for fixing of tiles. Now this is the substrate. Isme ek cheez aapne zarur yaad rakhni hai ki when I say to replace your cement with tile adhesive, it is not the total thing. The base is with normal cement concrete only. Only the adhesive, the material used for fixing of this tile, the final coating is of adhesive, and normally this is in few mm only. It starts from 3 mm. Aaj ki date mein, kyunki normal tile mein to 3 to 4 mm is sufficient, but aajkal kahin pe marble ya granite more thickness hoti hai, to wahan pe hamari thickness ye adhesive ki bhi badh jayegi. There are different types of tile adhesives, not going in detail for different type of surfaces. There are different materials available. There is a IS code which is giving basically three types of adhesives: cementitious, dispersion and reaction adhesives. So we are into cementitious and reaction, epoxy grouts and cementitious grouts, both we are doing. And these are the, as per European standard, these are the types: cementitious, normal, improved. And they have given further characterization: fast setting, slip resistant, extended open time, deformable, highly deformable. So these are the basic requirements, different requirements of adhesive. Hum aapko jaldi setting wala chahiye. Slip resistance means when the weight of the tile is very high, it should not slip down. So there you need a special type of adhesive, T. And extended open time means when you need more time to place your tile. What is open time? ओपन टाइम बेसिकली आपने ये टाइल एडहेसिव बना लिया, वॉल के ऊपर लगा लिया, उसके बाद द टाइम अवेलेबल टू प्लेस द टाइल. सो एक्सटेंडेड ओपन टाइम इज वन. डिफॉर्मेबल, व्हेन द ट्रैफिक इज हाई, इट हैज टू बी अ लिटिल डिफॉर्मेबल सो दैट इट कैन टेक केयर ऑफ स्मॉल मूवमेंट ऑफ टाइल इवन आफ्टर फिक्सिंग. सो दैट इज देयर हाईली डिफॉर्म. सो वेरियस कैटेगरीज आर देयर. वी हैव अ कोड इन प्लेस IS 15477. So this is giving the classification of various kind of adhesives. They are polymer modified, highly polymer modified, polymer modified adhesives with liquid admixtures. They come in separate packing, and resin adhesives. So these are different adhesives as per this. I'm not going in detail. I was just telling you that basically there are two types. If you talk about IS 15477, there are two types of adhesives. One is type 1 and type 2. Recently it has been further extended to type 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. ये 2004 में जो रिवीजन हुई थी उसमें टाइप 1, टाइप 2 था. जो रिवीजन हुई है उसमें पांच तरह के एडहेसिव हैं. अगर हम ये इसी की बात करें तो इसमें हाउ दे हैव क्लासिफाइड 1 एंड 2. अगर आपका जो फिक्सिंग मटेरियल है इट हैज हैविंग पोरोसिटी मोर देन 3%, आपकी टाइल की पोरोसिटी 3% से ज्यादा है, तो आप टाइप 1 यूज करेंगे, मतलब सिरेमिक टाइल्स, नॉर्मल टाइल्स. अगर उसकी पोरोसिटी 3% से कम है, मतलब आपका मार्बल, ग्रेनाइट, द मटेरियल जिसके अंदर पोरोसिटी है ही नहीं, तो यू विल नीड अ हाई एंड प्रोडक्ट, दैट इज टाइप 2. सो बेस्ड ऑन दैट देयर आर डिफरेंट बेड्स आल्सो, थिक बेड, थिन बेड, मीडियम बेड. कितना एमएम आप मटेरियल यूज करेंगे, इफ इट इज मोर देन 10 mm देन इट इज कॉल्ड एज थिक, लेस देन 6 mm इट इज थिन बेड, and in between it is medium bed fixing. This was a traditional method. इस तरह से हम करते थे, पहले लगाते थे सी कियोस्क जो साइट के ऊपर होता था. दिस वॉज द ट्रेडिशनल मैथड, बट इन मॉडर्न मैथड वी हैव डन अवे विद ऑल दिस थिंग. यू जस्ट हैव टू गिव अ प्रॉपर बेस एंड अ वेरी थिन लेयर इज अप्लाइड एंड दीज आर ऑल द फीचर्स. मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इज इन कंट्रोल, प्रॉपर एडेशन विल बी देयर, गुड टेंजाइल स्ट्रेंथ विल बी देयर, नो सोकिंग ऑफ टाइल इज रिक्वायर्ड. आप नॉर्मली जब टाइल लगाते हैं उसकी प्री वेटिंग करनी पड़ती है. No pre-wetting is required. Dry tires have to be fixed on your tile adhesive. It is self-curing. No curing is required after this product. In fact, friends, jitne bhi product mere hain, all these are cement-based, but they do not require any curing. And they are value for money, eco-friendly. All these things are there. How to use? I'm not going in detail. I've just told you it is very easy to apply. You just have to add water. Normally, we add 25% water in this. And these all are self-curing. No extra curing is required before or after application. They have got excellent waterproofing characteristics. That is very important. That's the reason I am discussing this product with you under this title. इससे जब आप टाइल लगाएंगे तो that won't allow water to penetrate. They will have very low shrinkage. That means the tile won't leave the surface and they will have excellent adhesion. As I have told you, mix ratio is 1:4. These are the normal parameters. Open time is about 15 minutes. After 6 to 8 hours, you can do grouting also. And for floor, it is 24 hours. VOC is nil in this case. Now, these are the test parameters of type 1 and type 2, various things. Application is very, prepare the substrate, preparation of material, application of material. So all these things, these are normal tools which we use. This is the base done like this. This is preparation of my material, adding around 5 to, as I have told you, 25% water. 5 liter water is being added in 20 kg bag of Tilemax. Make a proper mix, wait for 15 minutes again for making those polymer active. Hand mixing or trowel mixing is recommended. And you have to use the mix within 90 to 120 minutes. This is how we put the material and just put the, see the tile is pure dry. No pre-wetting is required. Base has been prepared. We are laying the material and then we will put the tile like this. After that, we can do grouting to seal the joints of tiles. This is trowel size selection as per the size of your tile. These are various do's and don'ts using your tile adhesive. You should not soak the tile. For tiles, dust, they should be dust free. The main precaution is that no wetting of tile is recommended while you are using tile adhesive. And they will give you quick setting also. They will give you waterproofing effect also. They will allow you to move at an earlier stage also. So all the benefits are there. Ready to use product, you need not add. There is a tendency, some people add sand into this product. No sand is required. It is pure powder, you just have to add water. So this is about, basically, this is our brand Tilemax. So we have, in type 1, we have this triple one. Type 1, Tilemax triple one is there. This is type 2. As I have told you, type 2, basically for substrate having porosity less than 3%. So triple 2. And this is triple 4. These two products are gray cement based. This is further enhancement to white cement based product. This is for your swimming pools and areas which are more prone to waterproofing problems. So these products you should recommend. And the last product, friends, which I recommend for you again with respect to waterproofing is Level Max. Basically, friends, aapko jaise maine bataya ki we have changed our brickwork with your नॉर्मल जो ब्रिक आप यूज करते हैं, रेड कलर ब्रिक जो यूज करते हैं, रेड ब्रिक्स हैव बीन यूज्ड विद योर ब्लॉक्स, रिप्लेस्ड विद योर ब्लॉक्स. एसी ब्लॉक्स हम यूज कर रहे हैं, हॉलो ब्लॉक्स यूज कर रहे हैं, फ्लाई ऐश ब्रिक्स यूज कर रहे हैं. तो उसके ऊपर पहले तो मैंने आपको ज्वाइंटिंग की बात की. पहले तो उसकी ज्वाइंटिंग के लिए वी शुड नॉट यूज सीमेंट, वी शुड यूज सम गुड क्वालिटी ज्वाइंटिंग मोर्टार. वंस यू हैव डन ऑल दैट फॉर प्लास्टरिंग ऑफ सच काइंड ऑफ सर्फेस, वी हैव गिवन अ रेडी मिक्स सोल्यूशन. उसके ऊपर ट्रेडिशनल आपका सीमेंट सैंड प्लास्टर की जरूरत नहीं है. दिस इज अ प्रोडक्ट अवेलेबल फ्रॉम अस. दिस इज लेवल मैक्स. This is ready to use. This is white cement based. You just have to add water, and this can very well replace your traditional plaster. Here the whiteness is 85% in this case. Bulk density is 1.48. Pot life is around 2 to 2.5 hours. And water retentivity is very high. When I say high water retentivity, that means it can be used both on exterior and interior. Compressive strength is more than 5 MPa. Very high compressive strength. आपके normal plaster की 2 या 3 MPa strength होती है. तो उसके लिए this is a better option. Again, repeating, you need not add anything into it. You just need to add water. And if you talk of costing, it is coming around 20 rupees square feet. आपका जो normal plaster वो भी इसी range में है. This is a simple mathematical calculation where we have done it for a 100 square feet area for a thickness of around 5 mm. And this is how we have done. So this is very much compatible. And aapke reference ke liye, I will quote, I think it is there in the slide also. There is one building. So no, it is not there. I will just give you example. Aapke Bathinda mein hi, it is at HPCL की रिफाइनरी बन रही है. There all the walls are RCC wall. They haven't used any brick in that, and not even blocks. It is a Maiwand shuttering frame structure, RCC wall, and उसके ऊपर सारा प्लास्टरिंग के लिए they have used this material. If you get a chance, you should visit that area and you will see they have used this material, and over that they have done their texture coating. See, this is the material. This is a sample done over. This is an HPCL refinery only. I had a full photograph also, but somehow it is not there in this slide. I don't know where. We have done many. This has been recommended in CPWD schedule also. In CPWD schedule, this you should remember as a civil engineer. Agar aap koi government building karenge, kuch bhi karenge, they will always say you to use the material which have been recommended in CPWD manual. So at CPWD manual, there are various clauses. At 13.86, they have given this material as 6 mm plaster on cement concrete or RCC cement concrete with white cement based polymer modified self-curing mortar. So they have written all the qualities. They can't write brand name. And they have calculated the costing as 205 rupees 50 paisa per square meter. So that's it, friends. I wish you a very safe journey in this challenging time, and keep yourself safe. Use your time in a very positive manner. Work hard, be a good person, and be a good engineer. Any questions anybody wants to ask, may ask now.
Yes sir, one question is there from Shubham Singla. Yeah. He is saying how much we need the thickness of wall putty.
Putty, normally it is applied in 2 coats, and the normal thickness is 2.5 to 3 mm of 2 coats taken together. And suppose, I would further explain, suppose Shubham, if there is a surface where the undulations are more than that, what is my putty doing? Basically, it is to take care of my undulation, to give you smooth surface. Suppose the undulations are more than that, then you should give a coat of level max first. If the undulations are say to the extent of 5 mm, 6 mm, plaster thick nahi hua hua, then give a coat of level max, the last product which I discussed with you. After that, you can go in for a single coat of putty. Yeah. Putty in any case, thickness cannot go beyond 1.5 mm in a coat, single coat. Okay.
Nowadays, acrylic putty is going on in a trend for more smoothness. सर मेरे को उसका कोई बेनिफिट नहीं लगा सर, मैंने करवाया था घर पे काम.
नहीं शुभम जी, एक्रिलिक पुट्टी इट्स अ प्रोडक्ट अवेलेबल इन मार्केट, बट एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू, जस्ट लाइक एक्रिलिक प्राइमर, इट इज ऑफ नो बेनिफिट, नो ग्रेटर बेनिफिट देन माय नॉर्मल वॉल पुट्टी. द रीजन इज दिस प्रोडक्ट हैज टू बी अप्लाइड ऑन सीमेंटेशियस सरफेस, राइट? सो सीमेंटेशियस, जो सीमेंट टू सीमेंट बॉन्डिंग, मेरा जो प्रोडक्ट है व्हाइट सीमेंट पुट्टी है, तो उसका जो बॉन्डिंग होगा दैट विल बी ऑलवेज बेटर. एक्रिलिक पुट्टी क्या करेगी, उसके ऊपर एक कोटिंग सी बना देगी, जो मैंने आपको लेमिनेशन वाली एग्जांपल प्राइमर के केस में दी थी, जेके प्राइमेक्स के. सो एक्रिलिक पुट्टी इज ऑल्सो डूइंग द सेम थिंग व्हाट एक्रिलिक प्राइमर इज डूइंग. सो इट्स ऑलवेज बेटर टू गो इन फॉर सीमेंट बेस्ड पुट्टी.
सो एनी अदर स्टूडेंट वॉन्ट टू आस्क एनी क्वेश्चन, एनी अदर क्वेरी? सर जो आपने ये विटामिनस फिल्ट ट्रीटमेंट के बारे में बताया तो क्या दैट कैन बी यूज्ड एट आर होम्स आल्सो?
या वो ज्यादा यूज मैम जितने प्रोजेक्ट्स हैं वहां तो नॉर्मली पीपल हैव चेंज्ड देयर कॉन्सेप्ट दे आर यूजिंग हाई एंड प्रोडक्ट्स दे हैव गॉन अप टू इपॉक्सी कोटिंग आल्सो बट ट्रेडिशनल जो हमारी नॉर्मल एक आईएचबी जिसे हम कहते हैं इंडिविजुअल हाउस बिल्डर उसमें आज भी अराउंड 50% बिटुमेन कोटिंग यूज हो रही है तो इट वर्क्स इट इज नॉट दैट बट इन दैट केस आल्सो I would recommend that you should go for minimum 85-25 grade of concrete. Oh, sorry, bitumen. 85-25 bitumen is a must. Oh, normally क्या होता है जो road पे use हो रहा 30-40 it's a very soft. जो road वाला bitumen होता है that's very soft. So that if you use that when it gets exposed to the atmosphere it will not serve the purpose. Whereas 85-25 it forms a brittle layer over your slab. So that is always recommended. और उसका पहचान भी यही है जब आप इवन खरीदने जाएंगे मार्केट में 85-25 विल बी कमिंग इन अ वेरी हार्ड शेप उसको ला के फिर वो लगाने वाला मेल्ट करेगा वेयर एज 30-40 या अदर बिटुमन दे कम इन अ वेरी सॉफ्ट शेप
और जो आपने ये वो बताई थी रोल जो है तो वो हाँ, क्या रेट में मिलते हैं सर
दैट इज टार फेल्ट भी है और अदर बिटुमिनस आजकल तो पॉलीमर मॉडिफाइड फेल्ट्स भी आते हैं दे आर नोन एज फेल्ट्स मैम एंड दे आर नॉर्मली अवेलेबल इन द मार्केट बठिंडा मार्केट में भी अवेलेबल होंगे देयर आर मेनी पीपल नॉट सेलिंग वो उसके लिए पहले आपका जैसे आपका आरसीसी साहब है उसके ऊपर वी हैव टू अप्लाई अ कोटिंग ऑफ प्राइमर क्योंकि डायरेक्टली बिटुमिन उससे स्टिक नहीं करेगा बिटुमिन बेस्ड प्राइमर आएगा वो बिटुमिन बेस्ड प्राइमर लगाने के बाद देन वी हैव टू अप्लाई अ कोटिंग ऑफ योर 85-25 बिटुमिन देन we lay that felt over it and press it and it's over
to isi bitumen felt ko kya dpc mein bhi use kar sakte hain
yes it can be used
okay to fir iski thickness kitni rakhni padegi wahan pe
felt to madam aata hi 2-3 mm ka hota pehle aapko ye pehle aapko ek coat bitumen ka hi dena hai uske upar you can lay this felt
okay
इसमें सिर्फ एक ही प्रॉब्लम है व्हाट इज द डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ यूजिंग फेल्ट इज ये व्हाट इज फेल्ट बेसिकली दे हैव यूज्ड अ क्लॉथ टाइप ऑफ हेशियन कहते हैं उसे हेशियन मटेरियल होता है हेशियन इज नथिंग बट जिसे पंजाबी में कह लो तो बोरी तो वो बोरी के ऊपर दोनों साइड इन्होंने बिटुमन लगाया हुआ और उसके ऊपर माइका लगा देते हैं ताकि वो स्टिक ना करे दैट इज इट बिल्कुल लेमैन तरीके से तो अब होगा क्या आफ्टर अ सर्टेन टाइम दैट हेशियन विल गेट डिटीरियरेटेड उसकी लाइफ इसलिए कम है वो थोड़ी देर में हेशियन अगर डिटीरियरेट हो जाएगा तो वाटरप्रूफिंग इफेक्ट चले जाएगा
ठीक है हाँ जी कोई और स्टूडेंट क्वेश्चन पूछना चाह रहा है कुछ किसी की क्वेरी है तो ही और शी कैन आस्क सो मुझे लग रहा है सर आपकी आपका लेक्चर ही इतना इंटरेक्टिव था कि नॉलेजफुल था कि बच्चों को कोई क्वेरी रहा नहीं उसमें सो थैंक यू सो मच सर फॉर स्पेयरिंग योर वैल्यूएबल टाइम एंड शेयरिंग योर बेस्ट नॉलेज विद ऑल ऑफ अस ऑन दिस वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड यूजफुल टॉपिक दैट इज वाटर प्रूफिंग ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर्स सो थैंक यू सो मच सर
थैंक यू इट्स ऑलवेज माय प्लेजर टू बी विद द स्टूडेंट्स विशिंग यू ऑल द बेस्ट
थैंk यू सर थैंk यू So thanks to all the students and participants for sparing your valuable time. So that's all for today's webinar. Thanks to all. Thanks for joining.